undertaken at various sort of levels of quality, I guess you could say, between different staff bases of TLAs and private clients and developers and things like that. So we really exist just to supplement the, in some respects, the technical capacity of our local people and to just enhance their interest and strength of their advocacy within the environmental space. And our operational structure is essentially those of us that work in certain disciplines like planning, policy, archaeology, terrains and mapping. All of those things that are required to understand proposals are sort of brought to local people and then interact with and being guided by a kaitiaki, someone who is fishing out of a lake or live beside it or growing up beside it, all those other sort of style of things as well. One version of this is with trying to influence within that TLA space is around things like plan changes. Okay, so this is one particular model where we exist to try and utilize communication open and to have some appropriate influence and to achieve some shared and reasonable outcomes with respect to engaging with the environment. Of course, there are a number of values that guide us and define the path in which we from and part of things like that. Within the context of the EWI management plan, which our office administers with respect to its region. So, you might have heard some of these before, Morabi, Kitai, Mountains to the Sea, Te Kanga Matauranga, all these beautiful concepts within Te Ao Māori that we are seeking to advocate for. Those spaces that are having potentially detrimental effects on. In latter years, that has forced us, and even to some degree in terms of interest, to try and visualise in a mapping way, style, cultural values, places and things. So, for the last 10 years, involved in the Kahurumanu cultural mapping project, which first and foremost looked at the 5,000 place names that are within Te Wai Kaurna, working with each of the local aid assemblies, and trying to really understand what each of those Te Ao signifiers means, and perhaps has any ramifications for us in terms of being advocates for the environmental space as well. And so, similar notions to what Maui was sort of talking about, trying to examine where some of those original localities were, and of course the methods by which our people interacted with them, and perhaps useful information that might inform perhaps a better managed space in a modern sense. So, I mean, I'm sure this is a Google Earth platform, but I'm just showing you where our people have sort of been working at. So a little bit of the building and trying to educate ourselves and present on with respect to some of those values. Now, to evolve that and to make it more meaningful within our organization's operational model, we were very interested in the Takiwa company and their ability to co-opt and bring in data sets of interest. Again, some of those issues that Maui was talking about knowing what's out here, knowing what might be useful, and where it would sort of sit with regards to our consultation and feedback rounds with partner organisations and clients. And so, on this one, perhaps?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's essentially the space we're in, and what Takiwai enabled to do for us, which was really interesting, was to overlay some of those things that we could call cultural, Tauranga style understandings of geographic space. So we began with those spaces that are quite familiar and obvious and fall out of our iwi management plan and our claim settlement legislation. So places like our modern camping areas where we have an access right granted by dock and lands and things like that. Our original native reserves, there are quite a few of those, and they themselves entail an understanding and an original agreement right made around food gathering and life-giving principle with respect to the environments that they were supposed to access. We also put on our tribal properties, our statutory acknowledgement areas, Element I, and of course our understandings of QQQ tie, which fall into a concept called Ngaturutu, which is very, very similar to the notion of catchment, from the mountains to the sea, type understanding the environment of QQQ tie. Because it is the Ngāi Tahu understanding, and it may in fact be a Te Ao Māori understanding, that what happens over here will have an impact in some way, shape, or form over here. So we get a little bit hoha when we see permission given for something over here with no consideration for what the receiving environment is going to happen. But at least with useful scientific data sets displayed in this way, we get to have a bit more of an informed sense of ballpark. That's a little bit more of an informed angry challenge or a question back to those decision makers and those panels. So we're also seeking to add some of those things that I showed you in Google Earth that will be prepared in a way that will be rendered useful within the customer platform. And we're going to have ourselves a pretty powerful instrument to inform ourselves and also to deal with those entities that they're dealing with. Some of the data sets that have been included so far fall within the general thematics of our iwi management plan, which we entitle after our hearts, all the things to do with the sky, or the earth, waterways, or what have you. And that includes some of the things that Calvin talked about this morning. Line work, land coverage, soil profile, groundwater extents. It's a very interesting one for us, and something that Ngāi Tahu would like to explore further given the current status of Christchurch's drinking water, which has been, might have been used now and again, but essentially down in Christchurch they were all examining the headlock situation. We were briefed on some of the scientific understandings of the genesis